Well, howdy, 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 folks. You wouldn't believe who I've got hidden behind my screen right now. You can't see them yet, but I'm fixing to introduce them. Y'all, if you've watched me for long, I think it's been a couple months, we interviewed Castro Dawgz, and we've got them again. And I'm excited to have them on here again. And the hair's redder, and the shirts look good. They have expanded. They are kicking butt and working their butts off, and I can't wait to bring them on here and share their story. I did put the link. If you missed the previous video I did with them, it's in the link in the video description. So hopefully you can watch that and get caught up. But I'll try to get you caught up a little bit here. Let me shift. Let's see. Here, now I've got you both on camera. So now y'all are live and in person for everybody. Yep, it's glitching a little bit. So you waved, but it didn't wave on my end. It did on my live camera feed, but not on the other one. So anyway, this is Castro Dawgz. And I tell you what, introduce yourselves. Get us caught up to speed for those that haven't watched the previous video, okay? And let us know what brought you to now, this update, this cool update.
Oh, man, we've done a lot since the last interview.
So go ahead, tell me this. Don't start me off at the last interview. Start me off at the beginning. What got you into this business?
Watching your videos, and I needed a way to provide income for the family, and I'm sick, I can't work for anyone. I had to work for myself, so we decided to get a cart, and we got the cart. Now it's a bigger cart.
Now it's a bigger cart?
It's a bigger cart.
So, y'all got started how long ago?
End of April.
Okay, end of April. And I'm going to show them. So you've been May, June, July, and just barely into August. And Packers Concessions here. I'm sure you saw Ken Packer with Packers Lemonade and Packers Concessions. And Louise is here from Brazil. And Riley's here. He's just did his third day. He's out there right now on his third day. So let me ask you this. You started. I'm gonna try to get your camera working better. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna try to move myself into a better signal, and maybe that's the problem, because y'all are freezing up, and I can't figure out why y'all are freezing up. So, let me see. Y'all with me still?
Yep.
Okay. So, I'm going to go back to here, and then I'm going to go back to here and see if it stays with you. Okay. The video's freezing up on Skype for whatever reason. If people are wondering, we're bringing them on through on Skype. So, I'm going to pull up a picture. Okay, and I'm going to show the picture of your, first I'm going to show the cool picture. I got Castro Dawgz Boss Man on this picture. This is the picture of you in that red, white, and blue cowboy hat. You sent me.
Fourth of July.
So I got that picture up, and then and then your bald-headed self on your logo in the background on the cart. So tell me what made you, you got a trailer now, but what made you do that?
I got a trailer because I wanted to work all year round. And the only way, and you know, we got paid for a bunch of events that we were going to do, and we got paid early, so we took the money and we bought a trailer. And we renovated the trailer, and now the trailer's in action. And, Now I can work all year round. I don't have to worry about not having any money for the wintertime.
Now, I've got a picture of you standing at a counter you built at the back of the trailer.
Yes.
So,
yeah.
Tell me a little about this, because this ain't a normal food concession trailer. You're actually going to put your cart inside it of the trailer, right?
Yeah, the cart's on the inside of the trailer towards the back, or that'll be the front, right? Because the back is the counter. So when you open the doors, that's our countertop right there. So the people come up, and that's where they make their orders. And our menu has expanded a lot as well. We put chicken sandwiches, burritos, burgers. What else? Oh, we got cookies now. And, you know, we're continuing to do more and more.
That's awesome. So, you said cookies? Are y'all making them?
No, it's the grandma's cookies.
Okay, I'm showing a picture of your trailer with the cart in there. You got your baker's rack in there. And,
yeah.
And so, you took the wheels off and mounted it in there?
Yeah, took the wheels off, created a wooden base, and then we connected the cart to the base. We bolted it onto the base, and then we drilled the base into the floor of the trailer.
I freaking love it. Miller Adventure says they love it, too.
It's solid.
Luis, he's from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. He says he loves it. Let's see here. I'm going to pull up another picture real quick. Okay, there's the side door. That's what I'm showing them is the from your door side, the regular walk-in door, where you can see the side of the cart in there. And then I don't think that's – let's see. Oh, the trailer's red inside. Did y'all paint it red, or how'd you get it red?
Yeah, we painted it red, and we put a wood floor. And we put lights laminate. In it, laminate, but it looks wood. It looks like a wood floor.
I love it. Who's nailing that laminate down in the picture?
That's the wife. Wife's with the nail over there. Clack, clack, clack.
That's the redhead.
Redhead.
I love it. Okay, so you've already started vending out of this, right?
Yes.
And tell me what you think so far of it.
Oh, it's great. It's been really hot out here, 91, 92, 100 degrees. We did a festival the other day. It was 100 degrees. And I got a fan in there to let the heat out. And it's so much easier to work out of. And it's great.
Setup is a lot faster.
Yeah, everything's faster. Setup has gotten faster. Going to work has gotten faster. Everything has gotten faster. I'm in a new spot now. It's way more busy. You know, people are asking me to pull up in their warehouses to vend.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah, it's great.
So now, before, you were right outside the airport gate, right?
Yeah, we're outside the airport. And now we're down the street. There's a company called Sapa, and those guys, they come. They're like my biggest customers, and they're like, man, you should set up over there with us. And there's been a lot of construction around the neighborhood, and because of that, a lot of my clients can't come down and get food. So I decided to move over there, and that was a rude awakening because it's double the people. And on top of that, it's my customers that went on the other side of the airport are coming down as well.
I love it. And so tell everybody about your kids, because you've gotten your kids involved. They're actually helping do the business. Can you explain a little bit about that and give us their ages or rough estimate so that we kind of know? Because a lot of people are worried about using their kids. And I tell them there's no child labor laws. You're teaching your kids good responsibility. So tell us how you do it, what they've learned and what you're assigning them with.
All right, I have my 11-year-old son. He's going back to school here soon, but he's a big greeter. He greets everybody. He gives them sodas, waters, whatever they want, chips. And I have my daughter. She's 13, and she helps out with restocking everything and helping putting signs up and all of our banners and everything. They help. They work great. They love it, you know, and the people love it. The people come down and say, wow, it's a family affair. And it really is. We did an event, a huge event.
A street fair.
And it was all of us. We took all the kids, the twins, everybody came. It was great.
I can't even begin to describe the value of teaching kids these types of things, because guess what they'll never do? They'll never starve, and they'll never sit on their butt lazy, because if they do, it'll be by choice. It won't be because they don't know how. And I think it's awesome. Y'all are awesome parents for doing that.
My kids love it, man. They love to come to work every day.
Our six-year-olds are already being little salesmen and selling all the drinks to the people at the street fair, getting tips and stuff. It's pretty funny.
Yeah, they get tips, and they're like, I got a tip. They get all crazy.
Do you care to, I would love it if you'd catch people up, because to me, it's a valuable piece of information about your personal struggles with schizophrenia, and the fact that you, one, have a freaking awesome wife and family that works with you, and are supportive, but you didn't just sit on your butt and go, you know what, I'm doomed to this style of life, I can't get a job, you had every reason not to go to work, and you chose to go to work, you chose to get out there, and I'm proud of you, brother. If I could hug your neck right now, I would. Because I love you for it. I love that you weren't ashamed to tell people. And I told you this before, but I feel like it's worth repeating. And I'd love for you to share a little about that struggle. So, because there's people in our group that have some disabilities or something going on, illness of some sort, and it doesn't appear, it's not like a missing arm, where everybody recognizes you're missing an arm. And so I'd love it if you'd share a little bit. And I'd love it if your wife would even share a little, if she doesn't mind.
It's a struggle. You know, to this day, it's like, I don't feel good. Like mentally, I don't feel right. But I still go out there. And when I'm in the truck, when I'm set up and I open those doors to sell, it all goes away. Like, my wife will tell you the whole story of how I would call and the things that happened to me, you know, in my mind and everything. But when I open those doors and the people start coming, it disappears. It's work mode. You know what I mean? It's work mode. And it all goes away. It's crazy the way it happens. But I have a lot of tough times. Tuesday, we had an event. And I was like, I'm never going to do events again. On the way to the event, with the trailer in the back, it was traffic. She's over there trying to stop everyone, because I don't even know how to drive with a trailer in the back. And I'm learning. This is all learning for me. Back to the trailer. And I'm worried, like, I wonder where they're going to make it, because put this trailer, because it's so big, I don't know how to maneuver it in. I'm not doing events no more. And she's like, well, we got another one they paid for already. So I'm like, damn, I have to do it. But once I got there and we set up,
it was good.
It was gone. It was over. Everything, the stress of going, it was over. It was
the nerves and anxiety.
It was 100 degrees. I never complained once about the weather. The people were great. We do a lot of stuff for the DHS with sick old people. So we met a lot of older people with disabilities, and it was great, man. It felt good. We got a lot of things coming up like that. We got an event that they called us because of our last interview. We got called by that guy, and we're doing an event for 2 days.
For charity,
to give back to the people. So we're gonna give them a percentage or whatever, but they invited us. You know what I mean? We didn't know who he was. He found us through the interview.
Holy cow. I didn't know about that. Or if I did, you might have told me. But I think that's awesome.
Yeah.
Packers concessions, Kim Packer says, they are an example of the American dream. I tried to fix the ones that are saying there's some problems with the sound. I tried to fix the sound. I did some adjustments to even out both our sounds. I hope that works better for you. Anyway, so what's your plans going forward as far as with now that you have a trailer? It gives you some more options. One, you can work year round, and two, you have more space now. You have some options open up. What's your goal?
Well, the goal is to, we talked about expanding the trailer, like putting in the required fans to make it into a stage four so I'm able to do breakfast as well as, you know, not only lunch, but where I work right now, it's a lot of, what is it, warehouses, and those guys eat hot dogs in the morning time, so it's kind of like, they eating hot dogs and burritos at 9 o'clock in the morning, then why do I need to do, you know, breakfast?
I'm with you. I'm impressed. I think it's so freaking awesome. You've been sending me pictures and stuff, and I love the fact that you even take the time to have the pictures and then take the time out of your day to send me them. I save them, you know, I star them and save them, and I'm going to show some more just for the people that are just joining us here, because you did, I want to ask about your sign here. Let me get the right picture up. Right there. Now, you did the inside of the, as far as when you open the big doors and you have a counter, you did that sign. Is that vinyl?
Yeah.
Like a banner?
Yeah, it's a banner.
Yeah, we just got one in the mail today. Because, that's how my Tuesday started. One of my banners flew off, and I lost it. We had to pay another $50 to get another banner. And then on the way back, we found the banner on the side of the street. So now I got an extra banner.
Oh, heck. And now you got your banner. Oh, heck yeah. Now you got your banner too on your on the side too. Do you have it on both sides of the trailer?
Yes, both sides, and in the back it says with credit cards, which we accept credit cards, and a little mascot, and then we just put out new ones with open. They're open vinyl ones as well with what we sell,
like a street sign.
We got so many signs, man. Like you can't miss us.
I love it. I love it. Now, you got your number on those signs, right? Your phone number or something?
Yeah.
Good. I was just clicking through them real fast, and I thought of it. Let's see. I'm trying to see if there's any questions. Anybody got any questions for them, please put them in the comments, and I'll try to get them asked. I think it's cool that what you've done and where you're headed. I like the fact that you added the cookies. Now, did you say lemonade at some point?
No, we've been watching, Angie's been watching your lemonade videos, and she's trying to get the lemonade recipe right, because we got three more events to do here coming up here soon.
Email me and remind me, and I'll get you the lemonade the right recipe. And if you want to do Ken Packer's way, which is with the raw sugar, not making the simple syrup, that's the more authentic way, and I like it better that way, and it saves you a couple steps, and if you do it right, it instantly dissolves, and I can show you. I'm sure Ken won't mind. I know his secrets.
And what of the lemon? Is it the lemons is a secret? Because she tried some lemons and she said it didn't come out right.
Well, it is regular lemons, but you want to get the right size, because a lot of people think automatically bigger lemons, more juice. Wrong, wrong, wrong. Little lemons, 140 count to 180 count, which is per case. That's how they do them, the 140, 180s. Okay, you might get a 120, 160, you know, that range. Anything anything smaller than that, like 80 to a case, 60s to a case, those big lemons, they are not that good for this. They don't squeeze out as much juice as a little lemon. They got more white pulp in them than anything. Yeah, John says, so you just rolled your cart right inside and added a counter. Cool, so you use fans also? I guess he's asking.
We used an RV fan. They don't have regulations of what kind of fan. You just got to have some kind of exhaust fan. So we put in a RV fan, and we hooked it up to the 12-volt battery with the pump.
Awesome.
And when I did, I just turned it on.
That's freaking awesome. I think it's cool that y'all did the inside of the trailer. Like, y'all did it.
Yeah. Want it to be us. That's why it's red, you know, we're red and yellow and black, and that's what the colors are on the inside as well, red, yellow, and black.
I'm stoked. I love it. So anyway, if you'll get with me, I'll get you the lemonade information and you'll be good to go. Let's see, anybody else? I don't see anybody else. Anything y'all want to say before we go?
You guys can follow us on Instagram if you guys want to see where we at, how we're doing. We've started that recently, right?
What's your Instagram? I'm going to add it up here real quick.
Castro's Dawgz 503.
What is it, like at Castro's Dawgz or something?
Yeah, it's at Castro's Dawgz.
Yes. She takes care of all that stuff. I just sell dogs, man.
I just add pictures, man.
Castro's Dawgz at 503.
Castro's Dawgz 503, yeah, all together.
All right, I'm putting that on the screen. That'll stay there. That way people don't have to remember it. It's on there for life now.
We have some people that follow us, some hot dog vendors, man. It's really cool, from Tennessee, from Smiley Dawgz and stuff like that. We love it, man. Those guys are really good.
Well, you've got a lot of fans, and I think it's awesome how far y'all have come in such a short time, just starting in May, basically. And, I mean, just blows my mind. Do y'all have a Facebook page too, right? Yep. John, they do.
Yeah,
it's the same.
Hey, you know what? It's really hard. It's really hard for me, but I'm fighting through it every day, man. Every day I'm fighting through it. Every day, you know, because I do it for the kids. I don't do it for myself. You know what I mean?
Well, I think it's awesome because you're doing way more for your kids than you can imagine. And then the value of it's like a ripple. You throw a rock in a pond and it ripples through. And even though you can't see any more ripple, there's still vibrations going across that pond affecting molecules in the pond. And so your good deeds, the things you're teaching your kids, that charity thing you're doing, that has a ripple effect on thousands of lives and possibly millions of lives that you may never know. And I think it's freaking awesome. Steve Schaefer is on here and he says, this is great. Exclamation marks, my son has schizophrenia. This could give him a shot at a real life. That's freaking awesome.
It's tough, man. You know, when I hear of other people with this, and I've been in the hospital a lot, man. And I haven't been there since October now, right? It's been since October I've been out. But there's been plenty of times where I thought I was going to go back in, but I think about the business. And I got to focus on the business. And when I focus on the business, you know, all my angers and stuff that I think, because, you know, I think a lot of negative stuff of things to do to myself and stuff like that I go through in my mind, you know, because I got voices and they talk to me and they tell me how low I am, you know. And I look at my kids and the business, and it just feels good. It just feels good that I'm able to jump over that, you know what I mean? Fight through that and continue this. And I want to continue, you know? This is kind of a lifesaver for me, really.
Well, brother, I love you, and I mean that with the bottom of my heart. And I love your family. If there's anything I can ever do for y'all, please let me know. I think it's freaking awesome that you put yourself out there. I told you this in the first interview and when we talked before the interview. I just think it's awesome how freaking cool you and your family are, and to have such awesome people around you to surround you, and I wish you nothing but the best. You're an inspiration to a lot of people.
Hey, hey. And you see, I got some color too, man, from being out there. Look at that.
Look at there.
He's got a hot dog tan.
I got the hot dog tan, man.
Daggum farmer's tan. I love it.
I had to wear no hat for like a week just to get the color matching.
Holy cow, man. You were blind. You probably were blind to people in the beginning. You shiny head.
Yep. Yeah.
Yep. Yep.
Well, if y'all, thank y'all again for doing this, and I hope we can do it again. I hope you'll do it again with me, and as you go along, because I think it would be kick butt to have a series of this for as long as y'all wanted to, so people can follow your story and see a real life. Because these people that tell me, oh, I can't do it, oh, it's too hard, oh, I got a bone in my leg, whatever their excuse is, or I ate chicken last Thursday, you've got every excuse not to do it, and you went and did it.
Yeah, it sat for a year. I had the cart sitting out there for a year, planning, and then we finally went out and did it all.
Well, Tony says, such an inspiration. Thanks for sharing your story and your progress. Tony, thanks for saying it. Carl Harmon says, love it, guys. Congratulations to y'all. You can find them on Facebook. Top right of your screen, you should see Castro Dawgz. That's their Castro Dawgz 503. That is their Instagram. And go follow them. Check them out. They post, his wife's posting. She's the beautiful redhead to the right of him. And she, look at that hair at the bottom. You got a slide. Let me move my camera. Hold on. Look at that hair. I love it. I'm going to do it to both of mine. y'all have a wonderful evening. Thanks again for doing this for us. And I wish you nothing but the best.
Thank you.
You bet.
Have a good kid.
It's all right. I remember last time they were running back and forth behind you.
Yeah.
I got to keep them busy and give them a little video game to play. They'll stay over there.
It didn't bother me a bit. I loved it because it's real life.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all have a good one.
You too. Thank you.
Bye.